I always love this photograph and I write about it very clearly. But what was so striking to me is that they also look like a family. Istanbul and Turkey provided this safe space, the writing haven, the kind of authorial location he was really hungry for. And it happened.
How did you escape from this world to be the writer that you are today? How did you begin to be a writer, in fact?
I'm not sure that anyone ever escapes anything. I know I haven't. But the best thing I ever did in my life, I think, was, in effect, flee America. And it gave me time to vomit up a great deal, mm-hmm. a great deal of bitterness. At least I could operate without being menaced socially. No one cared what I did. And I was not in danger of death because I had no place to fit in.
Afrika kökenli Amerikalılara yönelik bir dergi olan Ebony'nin 1970 yılı Mart ayına ait sayısı. Bir aşk ilişkisi başlığının altında ünlü yazarın İstanbul günleri anlatılıyor. Makaleye eşlik eden fotoğraflardan biri bugün artık orada olmayan Galata Köprüsü üzerinde çekildi. Fotoğrafta en solda yer alan Engin Cezzar, yanında Gülriz Sururi ve el ele yürüdükleri isim, Amerika'daki ırkçılıkla mücadelenin sembol isimlerinden biri kabul edilen James Baldwin.
When I discovered the connection that Baldwin had to Istanbul, I immediately started looking for work on this. I was astounded that no one paid attention to that location. And especially that he was in Turkey throughout the 60s, which is his sort of most prolific decade in terms of writing about things American, the sort of the nation, the state, police brutality, the structure of society based in racist history. And I thought, you know, if he lived in Turkey, that must have been very important. And it happened. So think about another country. It had been in a manuscript format for 10 years. He couldn't finish the book. I found letters in which he talks about how painful this novel was, how he couldn't wrap his, you know, head around it. And then he comes to Turkey and bam, within 3-4 months, because it's a new environment, because people love him, because people want to help him, because it's a hospitable place. And, you know, this was the haven, the safe space, the shelter where he found his powers as a writer again. This was exile, but most of all, it was a very fertile, authorial location where he could write, he could focus. He also was immersed in a culture that gave him new ideas. So going back to the picture on the no longer existing Galata Bridge, where Baldwin's walking hand in hand with Engin and Gülriz, this shows you the coalition he was trying to organize. I always love this photograph and I write about it very clearly, but what was so striking to me is that they also look like a family. They look like they are walking into a bright future. They are connected. And so if you think of the ending of The Fire Next Time, where Baldwin talks about the conscious whites and the conscious blacks who, like lovers, have to change the future and forge a new country. This photograph really is a perfect representation of the sentiment that it will take an effort across racial divides, but also national and international divides.
In another country, there's a kind of plea for people of different races to know each other better.
Actually, I think that if I'm a novelist with a message, it's only one, and probably I suspect that every novelist has just one message. Mm-hmm. And all three of those books, it seems to me the preoccupation is almost exactly the same. And that would be the effort that one has got to make, according to me, the very dangerous effort one has got to make, to deal with other people as though they were simply human beings, to deal with them in some way the way you want them to deal with you. And no matter what price, from my point of view, no label and no slogan and no party and no skin color,
yeah,
and indeed no religion, is more important than the human being.